Hello.
Good evening. Hi, good
Yes, good
evening.
evening. It's nice to have you.
Yeah, same here.
Okay. All right. A lot of persons are still joining us. Okay. Now, I think I like that smile. If you can just bring it up again, the smile and the voice. That's lovely. Okay. That's lovely. Now, should we call you a fun person or just a straight up sales person?
I can be both, depends.
Oh, you can be both.
Yeah.
Okay, I think the face I'm looking at, I can see a very straight up sales person. You can actually close sales easily.
Yeah, I'm doing my best. It's not really, I think it's something that comes naturally, and then you also have to like go out of your way to sharpen your skills in that aspect too. So we learn every day,
Okay,
yeah.
that's good. Nali Concept, thank you for joining us. Now, how do we address you? Do we just call you by your name or by your business name? Which one would you prefer?
Usually I like to be addressed or called by my business name when we're talking business.
Okay, by your business name.
Yes, please.
Okay, Fedima 2, welcome. Or Fadima 2. So, your business name, what is the business name? What do How are we going to pronounce it? How are we going to address you by your business name? Hello? Okay, I think she's going to get back to us. I think that's not network.
Yeah, that should be network because I couldn't hear you.
Okay. Messi Realtor, thank you for joining us. I was saying that how do we address you? Your business name, what is the business name?
Chibi Empire.
Chibi
Yeah,
Empire.
yes, please.
Okay. Chibi Empire. Okay. That's how we're going to be addressing you tonight.
Yes,
Now, can
please.
you just take us through a walk through what you do and the solution you're actually providing for the society?
Okay, basically I'm into the production of hair products. I have my own hair care line. We
Okay.
try to solve the issue of all hair related issues, ranging from roots, hair loss, and all that, like transitioning from relaxed hair to natural hair, which is what's in vogue. That's what's trending now. Everybody wants to carry their natural hair. So
Okay.
we're able to produce and provide products that is going to ease your journey through transitioning and also taking care of the hair when you are fully transitioned. So all hair related issues regarding hair breakage, hair loss, stunted growth, beard growth, beard grooming, kids. So it's not restricted to only women. We also have the men ranges too.
Okay, so you make the product and you sell them, right?
Yes, I make the product
And you also
myself.
provide the services.
Yes, I
Okay,
also
that's
provide the
beautiful.
services. Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. I think I'm already seeing a lot of people are warming up to patronize you. Maybe myself as well, if I want to grow my beards.
Yeah, sure. I think
Right?
I can see you carrying a full head, so you strike
Yes,
me as
I
someone
love
who loves
natural
to keep
hair.
a full head. Yeah, I can see that.
Yes. So that's lovely. We know what you do now. You make hair products and you also provide services around taking care of your hair,
Yeah.
having natural look, and not just for ladies, both for ladies and for young men who, I mean the beard gangs,
Yeah, the beard gangs.
yes. And the Afro gangs as well. They are growing right now. We have a lot of Afro gangs growing all
Exactly,
over the
exactly. Yeah,
place.
we ladies lately we tend to like guys with beards,
I don't know why. Do you happen to know why?
I just don't know too. I don't know. They look super cool, I
Okay.
think, with the beards
Wow.
than when they are bare.
We used to tease them those days, but now they are, I think the beard guns are the one in vogue right now. It's
Yeah, they are
okay.
the one trending, yeah.
Okay. Now, my first question will always be, do you have people that support your business, support what you do?
Yes. When you say support, are you talking about financially or moral support?
I'm talking about moral support. Those people that cheer you on, those people that encourage you.
A lot, a lot, a lot. My mom is my number one fan, and my siblings. Then some of my friends, and then some of my business acquaintances, people who we do business with, or people who have done business with or work with in the past. Like, they are kind of so proud of how far I've come and how I've been able to be consistent throughout. So I have quite a good number of very good people who support what I do.
Wow. Dr. Shogu, thank you for joining us. Dr. Shogu, we really appreciate this. Now we know that you are a business owner who has at least some level of encouragement from others, not like some other business owners who have their family member telling them, this is not going to work, go get a job. Now we know that your business is actually on the right platform because you have moral support already. Now, can you describe a typical satisfied customer? Your typical satisfied customer that you've had in the past. Can you just describe how that person felt or how the person made you feel?
Okay. You have a customer telling you your product works effortlessly. That alone is something I tend to hear often. Like, thanks for giving us quality products. And so you never can tell where or what products they have used in the past that they don't work. And then a customer telling you that I think that's what every business or everybody who produces products is proud to hear. Because that shows, it shows you're actually doing something right. So I have lots of those kind of feedbacks, and it's been awesome. It's sometimes, imagine waking up in the morning and getting to your phone and the next thing you're seeing is a customer review. It brightens your day. Like, it gives you this, it's like you know that feeling when you receive an alert in your bank account.
Exactly.
You know, even when you're sick, it tends to make you feel like you're not sick again. So that's how, you know, those feedbacks make me feel anytime they come. And then it gives me this push to want to do more, you know.
Do more.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. Wow, that's lovely.
Yeah.
That's lovely. Okay. So let's try to know you better. Now we know a little about your business. Let's try to know you better. Now, what will somebody do either to you or to your business that will really make you happy, really make you excited?
Okay. Anything somebody that, what someone would do to make me excited?
Yes, do for you or to you to make you really happy.
Exactly. Like, first, having someone saying, oh, I think you need this machine for your production, and the person gets it and gifts me. It's worth more than you buying me that dress or that shoe or that bag, because I know what I can do with that machine to buy those shoes or buy those bags. Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, so
I can hear you.
Yeah, imagine someone gifting me one of my machines or something that can aid my production, make my work easier. That is the best gift anybody can give to me. I think I'll opt more for that than you buying me a shoe or a bag as a birthday present. So,
I would say that is a super businesswoman.
Yeah,
that will prefer machine business expansion.
Yes.
To what designer bags or shoes or all
most definitely stuff. I'm going to choose that over and over again.
wow. Now if I want to invest in your business, right?
Yeah.
What should I do to invest in your business?
What should you do to invest in my business? Okay, yes. All you need to do is, for every business, there is always need for expansion. So for me, I think at this point in time or the level at which my business is at right now, I'm looking at expansion, you know, possible expansion. So it will be monetary investment will be more likely to help me achieve that than just, you know, any other thing. And then, we have people who can also invest in the aspect of, okay, I'm just going to put you out there. I have all it takes to put you out there in the face of millions of people through adverts or anything. That's also an investment. So we have people who can do that for you, even if they cannot do a monetary investment. So all you need to do is we sit down, we check our books, we let you know the terms and, you know, condition and how much percentage goes to you eventually at the end of the day. So it's two things for me. If you're likely or wanting to invest in my business, is either putting me out there for people, millions of people to see me and see what I do, see my products, appreciate my brand, use my brand. That alone is a very huge investment. And then secondly, monetary.
Okay. I mean, you are talking about exposure, somebody promoting your business and somebody investing cash into your business.
Exactly.
So those are the two things you are talking about.
Exactly.
So we'll call it promotion and cash, which is PC. So
exactly.
Somebody can put PC in your business, promote your business, or put cash for expansion.
Exactly.
Now, let me try to help you a little bit, right?
Okay.
Let's assume you have a product, a certain product maybe that will help to grow the air or to make it softer. And that product is 2,000 Naira, right?
Yeah.
Now, if I provide 2 million for a 2,000 Naira product, and I want you to make that product from me, not for me to sell for you, but for you to make it with my 2 million so that you will sell it, how much percentage or how much do you think I will make off 2 million?
Off 2 million, okay. There's a secret. There's a secret about production. There's a secret in production. And because of what you just said now, I'll need to take us there. Now, when it comes to production, if you produce your product by yourself from scratch to finish, you tend to make, there's so much money. The probability of you making times two of whatever you put in is very high. Like, for example, you're putting in 5,000. Probability of you making 10,000 or even 15,000 or even 20,000 is very possible.
Wow.
Yes, that's how production works. So if you're giving me 2 million Naira for you to put in my business, I can confidently tell you I can give you 2.5 million back.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's 2.5 million plus my 2 million or 2.5 million plus my 2 million, right?
Yeah, plus your 2 million. Like now the 2 million is like it's like a loan, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So you are going, I can confidently tell you, I can give you 2.5 million back.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. That's lovely.
Yeah.
Now, I want to also point our attention somewhere else. We don't know who might watch this video or who is watching right now.
Okay.
Now, if somebody has a big shopping mall or big supermarket or a place where they actually sell things, they can actually offer an assistant in such a way that they will ask for maybe 100 pieces of your product so that they can display it and sell, then remit your money back to you. Would that be nice?
Yeah. Awesome.
Okay.
Awesome.
Okay. So that brings us to distribution. So you might need people to help you to distribute your product.
Yes.
Okay. You are in Lagos or which city are you?
I'm in Abuja.
Okay. You are in
when
Abuja.
When we started, you made mention of distribution. When we started, we had about 24 distributors from different states. We had like about five And then we had like about 18 from other states, from different states and all that, including UK, I think, yes. So something happened along the line, like what we found out about some of these distributors is, okay, you've already made the name, you know, people know your product. So some of them are very corny. They get your product, you know, come to you as they want to be a distributor, they will get your product, then they will go out there with the idea of selling your product. But this time around, they are going to remove your stickers
And put theirs.
and put theirs. So for some, they will sell your product, saying yes, it's your product since you have referred them, because they are all over your page as your distributor. So you just feel, the customers will feel, oh, this product is from this person, and this person advertised this person. Okay, maybe this person gave this distributor the right to use a different sticker for their product. So instead of promoting your own business, eventually that product gets out and they are the one getting a return of what come, like maybe somebody else seeing the product but not with your labels. Now this time around, what they now do at the end of the day is they start buying maybe elsewhere, or they start trying to imitate the product to make more profit, thereby spoiling the previous brand that actually led some customers there. So we start having issues of, oh, this product, I bought this product before, the first time I bought it was like this, now it's this way, it's no longer like this, you know, and all that. So most times they use it, these distributors come with the disguise that they want to be your distributor, but they're trying to draw traffic, like pull your customers to them, and then they introduce them to another brand or cajole them to buy the brands they have. So at the point
Okay, I
we,
think there's a solution to that.
yeah, so at the
I
point
will stop.
we had to stop distributorship. We
Stop.
only have one
Okay.
distributor right now in Lagos.
All right. There's a solution to that. Maybe we'll talk off camera on how you can
Yeah, sure.
actually maneuver that and make it work to your advantage. It happened to
Thank
virtually all the big brands you can see,
you.
but they
Yeah.
found a way to sail over it. So that's good. Now, do you have any celeb or any influencer that you admire that you think when they support your business, encourage your business, add a voice to your business, it will be profitable to you?
Okay, I in the past, like I've been on social media and it's survival of the fittest. So I have
Okay.
quite a good number of celebrities that, you know, though one is faceless, but the kind of feedbacks I've heard from those who have used him or her, because I don't know, GLB, like a gist lover. You know,
Okay.
that's a page where I've been following back to back right from day one, and I've seen a lot of people, a lot of brands patronizing them. So if they are not doing something right, I'm sure they won't, you know, brands, you know, big brands that I look up to, like, oh, this brand is actually big, you know, they won't be patronizing them. And then another page, I think I the celeb that I actually, it's Tunde Ednaut is also a very big voice when it comes to Instagram, and I think Instablog. Those are the three so far.
Okay, Instablog, Gist Lovers, and Tunde Ednaut.
Yes.
Now, out of the three, the only one that has a face is Tunde Ednaut. The
Yeah.
other two,
Faceless.
how about Ubi Franklin? You think Ubi Franklin will have impact in your business?
Will be Franklin.
Yes.
The thing is, the thing is, Ubi Franklin, I think he's more of, I don't think he does influencing for products. He's more of
He's doing it
pushing.
now.
Oh, really? I've not really taken note of
Yes.
that, and I'm following him, but I
He's
see
doing it
more
now.
of, I see more of him doing media, you know,
Okay.
for more like upcoming, what do they call it, like all this
Artist and all that.
BBN people and all that. So I don't see him doing with people, you know, trying to push brands like ours. So I don't think
he's doing it now.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And somebody's suggesting in the comment that maybe a dance with Don Jazzy will do it for you.
Oh, okay. Don Jazzy too is a good one. I noticed one good thing he does is he supports businesses too. He supports small businesses.
He supports small businesses and all that.
Yes, exactly. Creative, small businesses. He tries to push them either monetarily or by being a face of whatever you're doing.
Yeah. What he does very well is that when he invites them, he just take a dance with them. That dance will
that's
do publicity
it.
Enough.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And it's amazing. It's amazing. You know, so free spirited.
So what we're going to do, what we're going to do, when we're posting this video, we'll tag him. We'll tag Don Jazzy.
Okay.
We'll tag Obi Franklin. We'll tag Today and Not. Then Insta Blog and Gist Lover, and see any of them that will take interest in what you do. Me personally, I love production because production is the hard part. Distributions and sales, well, is another hard part, but a lot of people are into that, but production, not so many people are into production. So
exactly,
I would like to encourage you, reach out to these persons. Now, there's a way to actually reach out to these persons, right? Any celeb you admire, if you try to track them down on Instagram and they don't respond to you, go find them on LinkedIn. On LinkedIn, they will likely respond.
Whoa, okay.
You understand? Yes,
okay.
You likely respond. And it is, most of us think that it is only when we offer money that they will respond
listen.
To us. But
exactly.
There's something, actually something else you can actually offer. You can offer a lot of other things besides money.
Like, I'm so keen to know.
No, I can see that you can offer a lot without that is not even money, and they will be ready to respond to you.
Wow.
Now, you can study what they want to do. Support them without even asking. Then eventually you ask. You understand? Now, Alibaba is having a show coming up on January 1st, right?
Yeah.
He needs all the support right now. But many people will ignore him until after the program, they'll begin to ask for help.
Yeah.
So, you can offer, okay, I'm going to give 5 products for this your program that is upcoming. Don't ask him for anything. Just 5 products I'm going to give to people that are going to come, the beard gang that are going to be there. I'm going to give 5 products. Now, imagine him helping you to give out 5 of your product or 10 of your product or 50 of your product.
Mm.
And imagine the response you are going to get. And you offering to help give out product is like him giving something free to his audience. He's going to love that.
Yeah, and exactly. It's going to serve as a souvenir.
You don't think? Yes, you don't think he's going to forget you after that? He's not going to do that.
No, definitely. Exactly. That's a smart one.
Yeah. Yeah. So there are several things that you can actually do. Once they have an event, try to help.
Try to be
before
part
you know
of
it, you guys are exactly. You guys are on the same boat. If you offer anything, and he likes the thing or she likes the thing and they give it to their audience, maybe later you have a program or you have an event also, you let them know. I think they would like to support as well the way they can.
That's a smart
thing. So I just gave you one way you can actually get their help without money. There are several other ways.
Okay.
Maybe
we'll talk off the camera later.
Yes, we'll talk off the camera.
Okay.
Now that we know that you do product, you do services, and we know the ways we can actually support you, we said the primary way is PC, promotion, then cash investment.
Yes.
Now, let me ask you a final question. What are the hurdles you have actually passed through as a manufacturing company? That's what I'm going to call you. I'm not going to call you a small company, a manufacturing company.
Yeah.
What is the hurdle you have been through? And how did you surmount this orders? And what are you going to say for anyone who want to do something that has to do with production that you're already doing right now?
Okay. the hurdles that are faced are quite. You definitely, as a producer, you're going to, or a manufacturer, you're going to be faced with a lot of things. Like first, getting raw materials sometimes can be very tasking. You might need a particular
Okay.
kind of raw material, and they are not readily available either in Nigeria. You might
Valuable.
need to ship some. Exactly. So, and maybe particularly that particular product you want to make, because of what you want that product to do specifically, you need that particular ingredients or raw material to get that done. So you find out that by the time you try to compromise, you tend to have issues of either product not coming out the way it's supposed to come, or it's not
Okay.
as effective as it was previously, which most manufacturers try to. If you're a manufacturer, you should look out for that, because there are somebody using your product for the first time and it worked, and then having to come back and it's not the same. You need to be consistent. You need to stick to what you already started. The only time you are allowed, or it's genuinely okay for you to change from whatever it is you're doing previously, is if you're upgrading, or maybe what you were doing previously was not just okay. So
Okay.
that is one challenge that I have faced. And then another challenge is, for you to get a certain product right, you need to be patient, like try to test, run, test, run, test, run until you get it right. You don't
All
you
right.
don't you don't yeah, you don't rush into, okay, they say if I do this, I'll get this, then immediately you start selling. No, that's a mistake that most people make. I also made that mistake when I started. So I realized that,
Okay.
yeah, and I discovered that, okay, I think when you have a new product or new idea, you calm down, you do the first trial, you do another second trial, and then you do another third trial. Now, while you're doing these trials, ensure that you're also giving it to people, or like a good number of
Use.
people to use, so that you can, from that feedback, you will be able to know if, yes, this is ready to be pushed to the market, because you wouldn't want to push something to the market that is not working. There's something about
Well,
production. If your product works, people will always come back to buy. People will always patronize you. That's the truth. So if you're going into production, don't compromise in quality. Don't go for quantity over quality. It should be quality over quantity, because
wow.
that's your the quality is your integrity at stake.
Okay.
So once you compromise, that's you compromising what? Your integrity. That's you compromising your brand. That's you compromising your product. That's you compromising your business already. So
Wow.
it's better somebody out there says, oh, this when I use this product, it's so effective, it's working. It's just that when you call them, sometimes they don't pick up. It's better to hear, okay, they don't pick up, or they are always not quick to respond,
Available.
available,
Okay.
than you hearing, when I use this product, it's not working. Now, word of mouth, especially when it comes from somebody who have used your product, is very powerful. I've had somebody who
All
referred
right.
someone to me like 3 days ago. The woman is in UK, and the woman right now, we're trying to close a deal of about 1.8 million naira with her. She wants us
Wow.
to produce
Wow.
in bulk for her. Now, I can
Exactly.
categorically tell you that if this woman never met that person, and that person never used our product, that it works, or maybe haven't the person heard somewhere that our product works, or seen that somebody uses our product and it works, the person wouldn't have referred her confidently to us. So, and
Yes.
we spoke for a very long while, and she was like, wow, it's like I've known you for a long time. So most of these challenges are, raw materials are not readily available. And then another thing is, always test run your product. Don't be in a hurry. Don't be in a hurry to put out products because you want to make money. Be in a hurry to put out quality products that is going to
Wow.
eventually translate to more clients to you. Not call out, you take people's money, at first,
you won't deliver, or
and you won't deliver. Exactly. We also had issues of, okay, when I started, people not trying, trusting, you know, but eventually, you know, people, I started doing things that made a lot of people believe that this person is not a scam, this person will not take my money, you know, so we hardly have the issue of people calling us scam. I'm not saying that we don't have people who do that, we do, but I think the way most people complain about that scam thing, I don't think we, on our own end, we have that issue, because I have people from outside Nigeria willing to do business, even what millions that I have not, they've not met me, they've not transacted even maybe a hundred of thousands with me, and they're ready to go, you know, overboard. So that's a plus. So if you're trying to be go into manufacturing, integrity is key, quality is key, do not compromise. It's better your product to be expensive and be effective than be low quality and shabby. Exactly.
All right. How about packaging? I've heard this from manufacturer that the biggest hurdle is packaging, that they have to get packaging materials from China.
Okay, yeah, packaging is another challenge. Now, if you're somebody who produces in bulk, you would need to minimize costs so that you can maximize profit at the end of the day. So what I usually do is, when I know what I produce in a year, the quantity by now. I've been in business since 2015, but this particular business of manufacturing, I've been in it since 2018. So when my brand grew bigger, I stopped buying in small quantities. So what I do is, okay, in a year, I sell certain number of products. So it gives me an heads up on the quantity of packaging materials I will need. Now, when you're buying from China, it's usually very cheaper, and then also the time you are buying also really matters. Okay. It determines the cost. It's going to determine how much you're going to spend in shipping them down. So you need to also strategize the time you are buying these things from China. You're importing these things down to Nigeria. So when you do that, you find that you buy things in bulk and at very cheap. And when even there is an increase in price, it doesn't affect you because you already have these things readily available. Yes. So, but notwithstanding, as a producer, you as a manufacturer, you still need, you know, the local connects, where if you have an emergency where you have run out of one thing or the other, you can easily get these things. So you just have a plan B in case your plan A, because you might plan for 5,000 pieces in a year, and at the end of the day, you've shoot over 5,000. So in a situation whereby you have an order that cannot cover the 5,000 that you've already planned, you need a plan B, like a local outlet here in Nigeria for you to get those things at a considerate rate, which is usually Lagos.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's lovely. That's beautiful. Now, I will call on everyone watching this and those who are going to see this later, that there are two ways you can actually help our promote our business. The first one is you promote by telling others about the business, you refer the business. And the other one is that you can actually have what we call cash investment into our business. And she's promising you're going to get at least 100% in return of whatever you invest.
Yeah.
And if you are outside Nigeria, people need this product. You can, instead of you trying to get local product from Nigeria that you have been looking for, and the way to ship them is quite hard, get in touch with her and our product will be easy to ship because they are local product, but yet they have international standard.
Yes.
So that's what I'm going to advise everyone listening to this or watching this to do. Then finally, what are you grateful for, or who are you grateful for?
First and foremost, I'm grateful to Almighty God that gave me the wisdom, the patience, the grace that I have today, because without him, I think I can't be here. And then I'm grateful for my parents for sticking out for me, allowing me to be who I want to be, irrespective of the fact that I'm a I'm a Muslim woman. I'm a young lady, single. That alone means a lot to me because not all parents around here can allow you to do that, you know, pursue your dream this much. My parents are very flexible when it comes to that, most especially when you are 18. They let you understand that you have to start owning up to certain responsibilities for yourself. So I'm grateful for my parents. I'm grateful for my siblings. I'm grateful for my friends that anytime they come and I tell them, oh, let me put my sticker, let me put this in this, let me put that in this, let me move this, they are readily available to help me. I really appreciate everyone, and then most especially my clients, my customers. Like, you guys are the real MVP. Without me, without you guys, there is no me. There is no Chibi Empire. There is no me at all. Because you guys are the one who have made me come this far, my brand. You guys have been loyal. I appreciate everyone who have been loyal to this brand and those who do not hesitate to tell other people about our brand.
All right. Nice to have you tonight, Chibi Empire.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me. All right. I really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
All right.
Keep doing this.
You have a wonderful night. Yes, I will try. I will try my best.
Bless you.
All right.
Do enjoy the rest of your day.
Yes, and you too.